In a rare move, President Yoweri Museveni today engaged the public on the ongoing Iron Sheet saga through his Twitter account. Tweets to the president ranged from accusatory to the call for action on ministers involved in the Iron Sheet scandal. Karamoja Affairs Minister Mary Goretti Chitutu will be in court tomorrow for bail application after her arrest, charge and detention last week.
Wait. I don't want to injure any person here.
The Directorate of Public Prosecution has confirmed receiving 8 other files of ministers involved. In the Twitter exchanges, AP Kogonza shared with the president a list of Iron Sheet's beneficiaries, including East African Affairs Minister Rebecca Kadaga, Finance Minister Matia Kasaija, and Lands Minister Judith Navakoba. He asked the president to at least make them return the Iron Sheets. The president replied saying some of his ministers had not internalized the NRM ideology on socio-economic transformation and they opportunistically engaged themselves in cheap popularity, trying to buy love of voters, which is why they get tempted to divert resources such as Iron Sheets. The president noted that some politicians took the Iron Sheets for personal use and said that was characterized as theft. He assured the user that those involved will be handled appropriately and must pay back what they took. At Aaron Kaviri told the president that he should not blame the public for not reporting corrupt people because he shields them. The president challenged him, however, to list just one person he has shielded from prosecution. To Mutyaba Tedious, who commented that the whole government system is corrupt and failing, the president scoffed at him, listing the achievements of his government. The president today wrote to Prime Minister Robina Nabanja about the Iron Sheet saga, telling her to ensure that all ministers implicated return the Iron Sheets. He directed that those who already used the Iron Sheets pay back the equivalent in cash. The president said those who took the Iron Sheets involved themselves in subversive activities because the intended purpose of the Iron Sheets was to lure the Karachunas out of raiding activities. He said denying them these Iron Sheets was like aiding insecurity in Karamoja region. Museveni said the ministers involved must take personal responsibility. The president also responded to other concerns raised by Twitter users on matters such as jobs, general corruption, and agriculture.
Yes, that's the report about the president's defense on his role in fighting corruption. But I'm here with senior journalist Charles Etukuri and policy analyst Mr. Timothy Chemonges. And we are talking this fight against corruption. Charles, are we losing the fight against corruption? The president has talked about political corruption. And then we have had Honorable Minister Mary Goretti Kitutu being arraigned before court. Mm. But we've not seen the other government officials, key of them, the Speaker of Parliament, her boss, the Right Honorable Robina Nabanja, the Prime Minister. They are moving on scot-free.
Now this is where we need to create a distinction. They are ministers who picked Iron Sheets from the office of the Prime Minister,
yes,
under the different agencies. They are ministers who picked Iron Sheets from Karamoja Affairs Ministry. So the list where we have Among, we have the Speaker, we have Nabanja, among the Speaker, Nabanja, the Vice President, was from the list of the office of the Prime Minister. The list of these other ministers like Lugolovi, Chitutu, and the other teams were on the list of Karamoja Affairs. Now, there are ministers who wrote to Nabanja and also wrote to Chitutu. In fact, that's how CID is apportioning the blame. If you wrote to Chitutu, because this supplementary budget was passed in cabinet, all these ministers were present. The supplementary budget was passed specifically for two reasons. One, to buy Iron Sheets and also buy goats. So these ministers knew when this issue was tabled in cabinet. So when the matter was brought to the floor of parliament and the money was passed by parliament, it was intended for that purpose. So a minister who wrote to Chitutu asking for Iron Sheets knew that Chitutu had no powers to give him Iron Sheets. These Iron Sheets were meant for Karamoja. And these are the things that CID is taking into account. A minister who wrote to Nabanja, but ultimately got Iron Sheets from Chitutu, also has some bit of explanation to do. Now, I don't believe we have lost the fight against corruption. The recent decision to by the president, then by the state agencies like the office of the DPP, SHACO and CID, of course, to have these guys investigated is a positive move. And we should commend Muzei for this. And we should commend the DPP for this. We should commend IGG. We should commend SHACO.
And we should commend you, Mr. Charles Etukori,
and also
for
the public
breaking
that
this story.
Mm-hmm. What we want now is, we talked about delays in prosecution. Mm. This is a clear case. Because Kituri is going to come out, she's going to appear in court tomorrow. She will be possibly granted bail. This case
possibly?
Is possibly.
Are you?
We still
have,
don't
do you
know
have
because
some
it's the judge. The judge. The judge is going to make her ruling.
Yes.
Then after that, a trial is supposed to be. Now in Uganda or Ugandan scenario, we shall have a trial fixed after maybe 1 or 2 or 3 years. Mm. We should have these cases prosecuted as fast as possible. Why? Because the IO who is investigating this file might be transferred. A number of things change. And the other news I also was also happy is that today we also received the news that 8 more files have been submitted to the office of the DPP. And we also received the news that on Thursday, possibly, some 2 or 3 ministers will be charged.
Mm.
Now, this is all, it's a positive move because these are still serving cabinet ministers. These are the fishermen and fisherwomen in the President Museveni's cabinet. So I believe this is a positive. If the president continues with this push, and let's just focus on iron sheets alone. We should go into goats. We should go into PDM because I'm told SHACO was in Karamoja, was in Acholi. We should go into other things. We should go into substandard government delivery services. I mean, we've seen schools that are almost about to collapse. We should go into Minister of Education, go into Minister of Works, go into these agencies, and let's remove these corrupt people. Then that this so I am still sure that I still have hopes that we haven't lost the fight against corruption. But also, my request is that as we do all this, we should do ensure that whoever is found guilty, especially the ones who stole the iron sheets for Karamoja, there should be heavy and punitive punishments. If I had the means, I would even suggest they should lose their properties so that the ones who come after them will know. And especially the cabinet ministers, we should start with them and roll this thing down. That's my wish. So I still believe the president is on course, this government is on course in the fight against corruption.
We have not lost the fight. We are in the process of
yes.
Though
I also
this
know
fight.
I also know that there is a lot of lobbying taking place. I had the bishop yesterday of Mbale, and this is where we lose, sometimes we go wrong.
Because that was public.
When somebody is stealing, he steals as an individual.
Mm.
We should not have respectable leaders of the community rally behind a person. A person steals as an individual, but you see, it has an effect of, now you imagine the thousands of Karachunas who missed out on the iron sheets. Now you are saying forgive. Now, because you see also, and the DPP was also very, and I think they said this is a piecemeal investigation. The reason why Chitutu is in jail right now, people have never understood, was because the investigators had a lot of rough time. First of all, even getting her was a problem.
Why?
Because, you know, she kept on dodging. I will tell you that Chitutu was summoned several times at CID headquarters. Parliamentary committee summoned her several times to appear.
Yes.
So her own character, by the way, contributed to what she's going through right now. Ministers who have appeared, it has been a systematic process because they recorded statements. Some are out on police bond. But they went back. Now they are going to maybe by Thursday some will be charged. So we should commend the government.
What do you mean? Some ministers have been charged?
No, some ministers. All these ministers were charged by the once. I think when the CID prepared, because I saw the statement. Today is our statement. Okay, in my interaction with my source on the story we are having tomorrow, was that the DPP would only peruse. They were charged because when the police prefers charges on you when they are recording your statement, these ministers all had charges. Because they are not public officers, most of them had, I think, corruption and they are charged under the Anti-Corruption Act.
Yes.
Now, what happens is that DPP was only supposed to peruse, but some of them, that is what my source told me. Of course, we haven't written about this because we haven't gotten the document. Are out on police bond, because police gives you a bond. I don't know whether some have been extending quietly, but they are out on bond. So on Thursday, hopefully, we will get 2 or 3 more charged. And the reason why I learned was that they didn't want to add all of them on one charge sheet. I think they are charging them in piecemeal. So let's have faith. All these people here, the ones who took iron sheets in an improper way, will be charged.
So you have some faith that
I
the
have
law
a lot
will
of faith,
take it.
I have a lot of faith. I have a lot of faith in the current CID team. I have a lot of faith in the SHACO team investigating this matter. I know that our people down in Karamoja will gets a bit of justice. And even the taxpayer will get some bit of justice.
Timothy, Charles here has told us that for Honorable Merigori Tekitutu, she kept on not appearing for questioning. And he was saying that this process could have gone a different way because they had to look for her and find her. I'm just wondering, the Honorable Merigori Tekitutu is the first cabinet minister to face the anti-corruption court as a sitting minister. Are there ways it could have been dealt with without her appearing before the anti-corruption court? Could she have resigned? Are there ways she could have avoided this, like the others have done before? What ways do you think this could have happened?
So the only way she could have avoided to be where she is,
yes,
is by not involving herself in what she did.
Yes.
That is the only shortcut.
Mm.
But once you've dealt or presented yourself in the face of corruption, the laws are clear, that should be it. But also she has to say
because
that
there are critics that have called for her to have resigned. Could that have been a little softer on her?
No, it's just to say even upon resignation, the law should still take its course. But also just to say my following of this very matter, I agree with Charles that the minister was not very cooperative, but also she seemed not to realize what was at stake.
Yes.
Because you could see her appearing before the committee, refuses to take oath, they summon her, she takes her time, and that kind of thing. So she was not very cooperative.
She wanted to speak off camera.
No,
but you see, the thing is, you cooperate, especially in that kind of matter.
Mm.
And given the circumstances, especially now when we talk about aspects to do with resigning, we know that our moral standing in this country, we are not yet there where even simple things can make a minister or any person who is in political office to resign. You've seen all these fellas are in government, names are out there, there's none shaken, actually they're even speaking boldly and coming out very strongly. That no, and that kind of thing. And so, in terms of morality, in terms of them resigning, I think that's not the solution. The solution is in the law acting. But also, I just need to comment on what you had asked, Charles, whether we've lost the fight against corruption. And to respond to that, I think that there are many other factors that you need to look at.
Yes.
In terms of the prosecution, how are we faring there? In terms of the number of cases within the entities that are being exposed and the actions that were taken, how much action has been taken. If you look at the local government, the resources which are going there, I know that even very little resources, a lot of resources still is being held at the national level, at the center, very little goes to the local government. But even what goes there still does not do what ideally should be. If you look at the manner in which we deal with some of the loans that we borrow. Actually, these days I saw one of the loans that was passed recently. There is a percentage, I think it is insurance or something like that, close to 12%, which is purely part of the whole mess in corruption.
Yes.
And so it speaks that whereas it's good to be optimistic and hopeful that we shall one day get to a place where corruption is dealt with decisively. Where we are, we are still not there. The will, the commitment, and the desire to fight corruption is there, but the actions are not there.
Question of resigning, we had a minister, the late Kivejinja.
Yes.
One time he was a minister of works, and I think he used fuel to repair one of these roads in his constituencies in Mijiri.
Yes.
He actually, when the matter was supposed to table in parliament, he resigned, but he bounced back. Of course, that time he resigned, but there was nothing done. I think that
he didn't face the anti-corruption.
But still, what happened was that whether you resign or not resign, we should. The thing is, let's hold these leaders accountable. If I'm in public office, I should not, because you see how if you read the stories we followed, you shared people's iron sheets using WhatsApp, using messages, using phone calls. It is so improper.
The investigations reports at the Prime Minister's office showed that. there were telephone conversations from the minister, her personal assistant, and then these Iron Sheets were released from the stores of the Prime Minister's office. I think that was quite odd.
And also, you see, what the detectives have done, even though these ministers actually did call Chitutu. Some of these ministers did visit Chitutu's office. What the beauty is that they have obtained their phone printouts. So they have been able to establish. Of course, I don't know that we have mechanisms to receive the voice recordings, but they know that on this day you called, 2 days after Iron Sheets were delivered. So somehow that conspiracy is built that you, because most of them actually, if you see what all of them are doing, they have shifted blame to Chitutu, which is a bit unfortunate.
And Charles, seeing how these different MPs or ministers came into the parliamentary presidential affairs committee saying that it was, she was the one who called the board.
That was choreographed. That those ministers,
and we have also seen the presidential affairs committee going to meet the people they are supposed to be interrogating, for example, the vice president, going to their offices. The prime minister has been interrogated in her office.
That was agreed because of the sanctity of the office some of those people hold.
Yes.
You remember, the prime minister is the leader of government business. In fact, some of these people didn't even record their statement at CID. The CID went to them. But that's why I was saying that some of these ministers, that security detail would have been removed. Because I will give you an example. When Chitutu went to CID headquarters, she went with her convoy.
And that speaks volumes about her fight against corruption.
That's why the president...
Are we able to bite the big dogs in this thing?
The president today went on Twitter and said, we should remind him of this 2-3 weeks from now, or a month. Members of the public, we owe the president, the president owes us a duty to keep on explaining these issues. Let's keep on engaging him. Let's make him trend on Twitter so that his handlers say people, of course, there are very few people on Twitter, but let's make this thing trend. The president today has issued a number of, a very beautiful explanation, his commitment to the fight against corruption. Let us also remind him that 10 years ago, we had different corruption scandals. Reports were done and submitted to him, but he never acted. Let's make it a daily song so that he wakes up. Because this Chitutu has gone to court. Thursday, some other ministers will go to court. Next week, some other ministers will be taken. Let the other old people also who committed this, because at certain point he has defended some elements who have been cited in corruption cases, which is a bit unfortunate. He has spoken today. Let's hold him accountable for what he has said. Twitter never forgets. So that's my prayer.
Thank you very much, gentlemen. I cannot exceed this point. I think we've had a very interesting conversation, but talking about the people holding the president accountable and the institutions that are supposed to be fighting corruption accountable brings in the issue of political capital. And political capital brings about survival and political stability in the country. That has been today's checkpoint, the fight against corruption. Until next time, I am Vivian Kansimi.